I'm going to be reviewing the Gtech Air Ram. I got it from Lidl for just £149.99.
I never expected to see an Air Ram Gtech Hoover in here. £149.
Which I'm led to believe is a bargain, if I'm to believe the price tag when it said the RRP was £199.99. The Gtech Air Ram, you've probably seen the adverts and the infomercials. They were quite ubiquitous at one point. This is the unboxing part of the video. You can click forward to the actual use of the product by clicking the time that I've probably forgotten to include on the screen. There you go. Let's see what you get inside. Well, on the box anyway, it's got the Queen's Award for Enterprise and Innovation from 2015. Now, I'm thinking that this might be the first generation of Gtech Air Ram, hence the cheap price. The box has got graphics all the way around, so no expense spared there. On the back, or is this the front? I think this is the back, yeah, because that's where the tabs are to open. It's got some nice graphics there of the benefits of it. So, Air Ram, light and cordless, LED headlights, up to 40 minutes runtime, asterisk, cleaner emptying, and then airlock technology. And there you go, it's got 5 stars on the Trustpilot thing, which is very good, isn't it? There you are. But because I've seen these reviewed so much, not reviewed so much, otherwise I wouldn't be making this review, would I? Because I've seen these being talked about so much on TV, I thought I'd give a proper, good, honest review. I paid for this out of my own cash. I got it from Lidl out of my own money. And I'm hoping this will replace the corded Hoover that I've got. I've got a Vax. It's very, very good. There's nothing wrong with it, except that for this small flat, it is a bit clunky and a bit too heavy, really. And let's see what we get inside. Right. Ooh. What's that? It's like a little comb, doesn't it? And it's got a blade on there. I wonder if that's to clean the brush roll of any bits of cotton or hair that get wrapped up in the brush roll. It looks as if it might be that. The instruction book. Anyway. And this is the Air Ram thing itself. The bottom bit. And it is... Do you know what? It's heavier than what I thought it would be. It's not heavy, but it's still got a more weight to it than I thought it would have done. There's the thing. What is that anyway? Let's have a look. The input is 100 to 240, so they've just given you a proper international one. That's good. But what's the output? 27 volts. 0.5 amps. 13.5 watts. There we go. Get that in there. Hopefully that's zoomed in enough for you to see. And it's a branded one as well, so they've not cheaped out on the quality of the product. That's good. These are parts of the handle. And they do feel a little thinner than expected, but obviously that does cut down on weight. But how strong are these pieces? I mean, it just, they do flex to the lightest of touch. The plastic is a little flexible. Yes. On this piece is where they've decided to put the Gtech name. Oh, on both sides. Yes. And that's the handle you push along. Okay, so that's reasonable enough. And I think this is it. I think that's all the pieces. Anything else in here? Or is that just... No, that is it. That is it. I think they could save on paper here. I think that's a bit excessive, really. Let's move that out of the way. and we'll see what pieces we've got.
Do you know what, future YouTube? Have a good smell. It smells very new and plasticky. Sorry, just having a good smell myself there. Smells very nice. Smells very new.
Yes. I think this feels quite nice. You know, like I say, the plastic does feel a little bit too tacky for my liking. But it depends how well it works, doesn't it? I just love peeling that plastic off. Right. Let's get this clipped together because I'm going to have to charge the battery up first. That's why I'm unboxing it and I'll do the proper working of it later on in the video. Easy instructions. This is model number AR29. I'll have to look that up and I'll let you know if this is the first generation or not, if I can find that information out. Inside there's a do's and don'ts, and then there's a what's his name himself? Nick Gray. He's the inventor and owner of Gtech. And it says, I started Gtech to create sensible, easy-to-use products that do a great job. Your opinion is important to us, and we'll use your feedback to improve our products and services, and to let other people know what it's like to be part of the Gtech family. Well, does that mean that people have already given the feedback on this one, and there's a later version? We'll find that out, hopefully. And, yes. Very, very easy, and it shows you how to put it together. Take the battery out to charge it, or you can leave in situ. Obviously, I'm probably going to be leaving it in because I don't have a spare battery. You want to get one battery. Maybe that is something they've expanded on. Maybe the other versions of this give the option of having an extra battery, which I do think would be useful maybe for larger houses, but I don't know yet, do I? Apparently, it gives you 40 minutes run time. The battery can be charged from flat in 4 hours. The state of the battery indicator will show 4 solid green lights when it is charged. It is okay to charge for 1 hour for a burst of cleaning. Replace the battery by sliding it down into the head assembly. It will click into place. Well, I'm going to charge it up whilst it's in situ. She'll turn it on and it shows you how to wash the brush and blah 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 blah. And if forward lights show, that means that the brush bar's got stuck and you've got to sort it out, whatever the problem is, and it'll force you to wait 10 seconds when turning it back on. Very simple. Very simple, clear instructions. Let me put this together. The first bit that goes in, you've got to pull this green bit out like this, and that releases that bit, and then you put in this bit. And then you clip that green bit down and that clamps that bit on. There we go, so that's that bit on. And then that clicks up like this. Then it says to clip all the rest of the bits together. Not totally sure how they go yet, but I'm figuring it out. That bit goes on, then it's this bit it says. Is it this bit? Oh, that's a firm click. That's a very firm click. That bit goes on. And then it says it's this bit. Is it that bit? I don't know. Maybe, is it that bit or not? Where does this bit go then? What's this bit for? Is this bit that bit? No. That bit must go in there, like so. Is it that bit? Oh no, maybe not. Oh, I'm confused now. I don't want to put that in. That bit's got a springy bit on it. Maybe that does go on there. Is it just like a megalith? Oh, it's just a very fine fit. Oh, that's a fine fit on there. And then that bit goes on like that. Oh, I see. And then on the back, there's a button that you press so that it goes down further. And that's so you can store it away somewhere. And I suppose if you want the extra space, you can put it on the door or something like this. if you've got something to hang it up with. That is really light. That is actually really light. Much lighter than the normal Hoover. That's actually very good. And it was as simple as that to fix together. That's really good. And then the button on the bottom is what you press to release it. That's really good. I'm going to show my leg now to push it along. Yeah, that's really good. Now on the hard floor, that sounds quite... Ooh, that's not a good sound, is it? But maybe when it's obviously working, it'll be a different sound. I'm not going to turn it on yet. I'm going to charge it up and do it properly. Do a proper review. The cable is quite short. It's only about a metre and a half. I'm really looking forward to trying this actually. We've got quite a few dust bunnies, I think some people call them. And we've been using the sweeping brush a lot and this very small handheld Hoover to Hoover up, because getting the big corded Hoover out is a bit of a pain, because this is what I'm hoping to replace. It's very heavy. And it's obviously got a cord on it. And this is incredibly light. I'm going to plug it in for a charge. You see, the cables, I would have preferred at least 2 metres rather than 1.5 metres, because plug sockets are usually quite high now in newer build houses. And this is only just reaching. Look at this. It's only just reaching to the base. Yeah, that's... That only just reached to the base. Anyway. Let's... Oh, and it did need a charge, because when I turned it on, that very... thin green light there is just very slowly blinking. That's telling me that it did need a charge. No weight in that really at all. When I first picked it up, I was thinking that was heavier than I thought it'd be, but once it's all put together and the way you carry it around, obviously the weight is distributed differently. This is what it's taken over. This weighs 6 kilograms. I can lift it above my head, but if I do it like that, I think I'm going to have all my muscles shoot out. Outside of the flat is obviously the communal stairway. And the cleaner has just been round and over the stairs. I can't believe it. However, because they use a Henry Hoover, and you know how much I hate Henry Hoovers, I did a YouTube video about it and it's got lots of views. I can't stand Henry Hoovers. They're rubbish. And I'll show you. See? Look. Look at all this mud and bits of grass and everything it's left. Now, admittedly as well, it is that type of carpet that never is easy to hoover. However, Henry Hoovers I find are notoriously bad at picking up. And I've been round to hoover this. Once again, this is not a slight on the couple that come round to clean the flat. It's just because of the naff hoover they're given to hoover up with. This is appalling. Look at it. It looks like they're not even bothered, but they really have.
My flip-flop came off. Let's see how noisy it is. This is the first turn on. Oh, I better take the packaging off, hadn't I? There we go. Is it as loud as an Henry, or is it quieter? That's not too bad. You could still have a conversation with that on. That's actually quite nice. All of the smell of new plastic. That's not too bad. Noise-wise, if someone had that on, you might have to turn the telly up a bit. That's not very loud at all. Well, there you are. 81 decibels, and this is a cheap thing off of Amazon, but I don't think it's accurate, but I think it's roughly right. Look at the state of this. This is meant to be just blue, and it's brown. I'm going to hoover this up with the Gtech. Just shoved it around there. What I've noticed on this particular carpet is because the grain runs that way, it seems to be flicking some of the bits up as well. Because of the rubber bits on the bottom, which is meant to be for hard floors, it's flicking that up. But as you can see on the bottom, look, it is picking up a lot more muck. Oh, if I hold it under the camera, you'll see. So that's the rubber bits that's flicking up a few of the little bits, but that's because of the grain of the carpet, but it is picking quite a lot up. I'm going to finish off this square, then I'll go in lower with the camera and we'll see the difference. Right, I've just finished this little bit and I am giving it a bit of a let off with this particular carpet because this carpet is awful, but I can definitely see a difference, but it's not perfect, as you can see there. I mean, I'll get the corded one out in a minute and we'll see how that one does. And I'm going to attempt to do some stairs with it because I think this is where, if you live in a house rather than a flat like I do, there might be more of an issue. I don't think he meant to do it with this particular model or not, but I've took the big handle off, which is really easy to do. You just pull this green tab out and all the handle comes off. And I want to try and over these steps. No, absolutely not. This, even though it's light when it's on the handle, this is far too awkward to hoover with your bare hands. This is quite a workout, actually. Nah, this is definitely only suitable if you live in a flat. Now let's give it a really difficult task of trying to do this stuff. Now this stuff's even worse than the carpet, isn't it? Now, I'm not too sure if you saw there or not, but once again, it's got the issue of the airlock technology actually flipping some little bits up. But... oh, it's falling out. That's no good. What's happening there? All right, well, maybe that is because I'm tipping it upside down, but some bits fell out there. So it's not really locked them in very well, though, has it? But it is picking stuff up, look. Look at the fluff it's picked up. I will empty this on camera because obviously I want to know how easy it is to empty. Just try an assortment of doormats. all the directions possible, and it's all right. It's clearly better than a Henry Hoover. If your previous Hoover is a Henry Hoover, and you've got carpets like this, there's only two reasons for this kind of carpet. One, price, and two, durability. But it's not a particularly very good carpet. It's difficult to vacuum. It's all right on this kind of carpet. On the doormats, it was all right. But I'm gonna go over this with a vax, and we'll see the difference. Now that Hoover's actually a very good Hoover. It's a bit old, but it's still good. I don't know if you'll be able to tell the difference or not. In real life, can I tell the difference? Absolutely. There's incredibly little there. Like I say, they're lovely and light to carry around. I want to see if the Gtech just blows this stuff around or actually picks it up. This is obviously inside the flat now. This is it's going to be its main job. And if it can't do this, this is when buyer's remorse will kick in. I hope this works. Please don't just blow it around. Definitely better for hard floors. It's done a really good job there. I really thought it was just going to flick or blow the dust around. I'm very impressed with that, actually. And I'm glad I don't have carpets. If you've got that horrible blue carpet stuff, it's definitely better than a Henry. Absolutely. But I think if you've got thicker pile carpets, I think this is going to struggle, because even on that blue carpet, it didn't sound particularly powerful, did it? Not too sure if you can see them or not, but these dust bunnies there. Oh, good grief, that's terrible. It's hard to see on the grey floor. Let's get the Gtech in, and we'll see in much better light if it just blows it around or actually just suck it up. Oh, there was a bit of blowage there. I've just figured out why that time it blew it about just a little tiny bit, but still blew it about. This is the air outlet thing. If you're hoovering up next to a skating board, it might be better to go that way rather than that way. Well, that's a weird thing to take into consideration, isn't it? Oh! That's brilliant! I just realised I've been wasting time if you've got hard floors. That's funny. You could just leave it. Buyer's remorse. Yes. I wanted to get rid of this. It's definitely got its plus points, absolutely. Because up until now, we've been running around the flat with this little thing from Lidl. And it's Lidl's own thing. You know, going around the skating board to that. Because this was just too big and cumbersome and wiry to take around the flat to over up with. It just wasn't worth it. By the time you've unraveled it and this, that, and the other, it's felt as if you'd spent more time doing that than actually using it. This is gonna get used. However, I just know for a fact we're gonna really miss all the attachments and whatnot. There's so many gimme quotes I could be doing right now, but I'm not gonna, because it's not Sunday outside. On that note, whatever comments you leave on this video will be mentioned on Sunday outside. Anything else I can say about it? Well, let's get it emptied and see where it picked up. Now, I did look at the reviews for this, and there are thousands, absolute thousands of good reviews for it. 5 stars and 4 stars and whatnot. Obviously, there are stupid people. One of the reviews I saw for this was, stopped working after a few months. All hair got caught up in the brush roll. 3 stars. Stopped working. Red light came on. Won't work. Well, empty the flipping over then, was all you could say to that. Well, this is... Oh, that's very easy. That just clicks out like that. Oh, look, it's even picked up bits of the carpet. That's funny. That means that this is probably the most powerful vacuum cleaner that carpet has ever had. If it's picking up loose bits of the blue carpet, that is hilarious. Well, there you are, look. Clearly better than... Oh, how old's that carpet? I think these flats built in 2000, so that's 21 years. And this is the best vacuum cleaner that that carpet has ever had. There you go. There you are. This is on the outside, though. That's a bit weird. It's on the outside of the thing. Right. Let's see how much it picked up. Look at it all. Right, you unclip that bit and empties with a slide, he says. And there you go. That's, yeah, not as clean as it makes out in the adverts. I mean, I've still got quite dusty hands all over because some of the dust had got to the outside. Maybe that was my fault though when I tipped it upside down. Maybe. Maybe that's what that was. That could be my fault. That could be user error. Super duper quick sum up. If you've not watched the full video, if you can't be bothered or if you're too impatient, on the whole, a little bit of buyer's remorse because it's not going to take over the proper full-on vacuum cleaner. It feels weird saying that because I like saying Hoover. Everyone in the UK just says Hoover. If you've got pets and if you've got kids, I don't think this is going to be a big enough bin for you. It's going to fill up very quickly and you have to keep emptying it very often. This is good for, I'd say, an intermediate Hoover up. Instead of dragging out your Hoover, you're probably going to be dragging out this a bit more often and leaving the wired one to gather dust. Irony. If you've got guests coming round at a short period of notice, as long as they're not Hyacinth Bouquet attending, this may be a good option as well. I can only imagine with pets, this is going to be a nightmare because this is going to fill up very quickly, especially if they're molting. A little bit of buyer's remorse I've got because I know that I'm going to miss not having any attachments for this to go in between the crevices, I hate that word, crevice, of the settee and underneath the settee and everything. That's not going to get under there because there's no attachment thing to get under there. But I'm not overly disappointed with it. I'm still happy with it. Would I have paid £150 for it if I'd had a practice go with it first? No. I think this is a fairly average. I think if I was to have paid a different brand for this kind of cleaning power, I would have been happy to pay about £80 to £100 for it rather than £150. And obviously that's just a special offer from Lidl. This is meant to be £200. There is later versions of this vacuum cleaner, but I'm doing this one because they're still making it and it's probably going to be reduced in price once the later versions of this are distributed. This is going to be the basic one, isn't it? That's my overall review. If you've got kids, if you've got pets, no. If you've got really thick pile carpets, no. If you've got hard floors or very thin pile carpets, yes. If you've got really cheap carpet, no. See what I mean? These 5-star reviews, I don't think take into account everything. I've tried this now on many different kinds of flooring, haven't I? Different rugs and whatnot, different mats and hard floor. Definitely suitable for hard floor, depending which way you go. Yeah, and that's my overall conclusion. Thanks for watching. Scratch spell me. Bye. Way better than a Henry though, definitely. If you've only got an Henry, then get a Gtech, because the Gtech is better than the Henry.